brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبيه ومصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وبعد, dear viewers everywhere, welcome to a new edition of Correct Your Citation. Inshallah, today we resume the recitation and explaining the ayat of Surah Al-Waqi'ah, this very beautiful surah. And as usual, after welcoming our studio guests, Assalamu alaikum, all of you, and thank you for joining us. Would kindly request our dear brother, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, to recite from ayah number 41 through ayah number 62 of Surah Al-Waqi'ah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين وكانوا يصرون على الحنث العظيم وكانوا يقولون أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون أو ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الهيم هذا نزلهم يوم الدين نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون أفرأيتم ما تمنون أأنتم تخلقونه أأنتم تخلقونه أم نحن الخالقون نحن قدرنا بينكم الموت وما نحن بمسبوقين على أن نبدل أمثالكم وننشئكم فيما لا تعلمون ولقد علمتم النشأة الأولى فلولا تذكرون
جزاك الله خيرا بارك الله فيك May Allah bless you and your family سورة الواقعة classified people on the Day of Judgment into three categories. Two parties will be saved, but one party will be in a higher level than the other. Al-Muqarrabun, Al-Sabiqun. And the lower party will be Ashabul Yameen, who will receive the record in their right hands, yet they will be still from among the dwellers of heaven. Then the third category, all the mushrikeen together. All those who set partners to Allah in worship together. All those who did not believe in the oneness of Allah, did not believe in any of the messengers of Allah, or denied the day of judgment, the day of gathering, the day of resurrection, they will be all gathered together in one place, suffering of one fate, which is an eternal abode in the hellfire. May Allah protect us all. They are called Ashabu Shimal. As-Sahib is the companion or the owner in Arabic. They will be given this position as if they deserve it, and they do deserve it, and it will be inseparable from them. They will always remain on the left side, and they will be recognized as the party which will be destroyed. Ma ashabu shimal. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned some of the punishment which He has prepared for them, of the exceedingly hot wind and the boiling water that they will drink, and the kind of food that they will be fed in hell. May Allah protect us all. Then Allah the Almighty mentioned the reason why they're being mistreated or being punished and tortured in hell. Why they were sat on the left side of the throne and they were given the record with their left hands. And when it comes to al-mushrikeen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not classify them as, well, there are some mushrikeen better than others. No. Al-kufr kulluhu millatun wahida. All disbelief is the same. Those who set partners to Allah in worship by saying that God has a son, or by saying that God had a wife, or by saying that God is more than one, or by denying entirely the presence of the Creator, will be all treated the same. Which means that they will reside eternally in the fire of hell. Why? Because Allah the Almighty says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَٰلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ افْتَرَى إِثْمًا عَظِيمًا. Allah does not forgive sitting partners to Him in worship at all. Yet any sin beneath shirk, lesser than shirk, no matter how major is that sin, is subject for forgiveness, especially when the person seeks forgiveness. And whosoever takes partners to Allah in worship, فَقَدْ افْتَرَى إِثْمًا عَظِيمًا. He has committed such a great sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُتْرَفِينَ. During life, they were living in joy, they were living in delight, they were indulged in luxury. Yet, they did not benefit of any of that. They did not utilize any of the faculties of senses in order to reflect upon the Creator or who granted them all those gifts and this luxury. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَانُوا يُصِرُّونَ عَلَى الْحِنْثِ الْعَظِيمِ. يُصِرُّونَ, they insisted. And by the way, it is mentioned in the affirmative in this ayah. And those who studied with us in Surah Al-Imran, among the traits of Al-Muttaqeen, وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. So we're dealing with the term of Al-Israr. Al-Israr means insisting and persistence. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَهْلُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابُ الشِّمَالِ, they deserve to enter fire because they persisted on committing shirk. They insisted and disbelieving in Allah the Almighty. So they deserve to enter fire. Al-Hinth al-Azim is the great sin, and the greatest sin ever is what? Al-Shirk. To take partners to Allah in worship. While in Surah Al-Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned from among the traits of Al-Muttaqeen, He said, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Muttaqeen are human beings like everybody else. They committed sins as well. But how could they commit sins and they're righteous? They're righteous because whenever they committed sins, they realized that they were in error. فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم they rush to seek forgiveness. ذكروا الله they remembered Allah فاستغفروا لذنوبهم so they seek forgiveness for their sins. ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله again the oneness of Allah and who besides Allah forgives sins the answer is none most surely. ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون and they did not persist in committing the sins knowingly. No, once they were reminded, they rushed to seek forgiveness. So this is a quality which made those people righteous versus the evil trait of al-israr, which made those people, ashab al-shimal, eligible to enter hellfire and to reside therein forever, which is insisting, no matter how many proofs, evidences, indications of the oneness of Allah, messengers and books, they neglected all of that. وَكَانُوا يُصِرُّونَ عَلَى الْحِنْثِ الْعَظِيمِ وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ Repeatedly, I mentioned in more than one program, belief in Allah the Almighty and in the last day, which means resurrection, gathering, accountability and reckoning, enter in heaven or hell, that's called al-yawm al-akhir. That is the meaning of to believe in the last day. There will be life after death. There will be reckoning. We'll be resurrected. So belief in Allah and belief in the last day are inseparable and indivisible. You can't say, I believe in Allah, but I don't believe in life after death. Then you are a disbeliever. You can't say, La ilaha illallah, but no Muhammad Rasulullah. They are inseparable. You can say, I believe in everything, but I don't think that we will be resurrected once again after we die, because this is the claim of the disbelievers. وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَثَلًا وَنَسِيَ خَلْقَهُ قَالَ مَنْ يُحْيِي الْعِظَامَ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ قُلْ يُحْيِيهَا الَّذِي أَنْشَأَهَا أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وهو بكل خلق عليم. سورة ياسين. Allah is referring to the Meccan chief who came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم with a dead bone, a bone of a dead person, very old, decayed. Then he rubbed it between his fingers and said, Oh Muhammad, do you claim that your God will bring this bone back to life? He said, most surely, yes, indeed, Allah will bring it back to life and he will cause you to die. Then he will resurrect you and send you to hell if you do not believe in life after death. So why they ended up in hell? وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ They used to say, أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُثُونَ Is it possible after we die and we turn into dust and rotten bones, we will be resurrected? Yes, indeed. أَوَآبَاؤُنَا الْأَوَلُونَ And also our forefathers, those who died since the creation of Adam and Eve, will be brought back to life? These were their questions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now will deliver the answer. They constantly ask these questions and they were being sarcastic. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as he said in Surah Yasin, that as he was able to create us from the scratch in the very first time, he will be able to resurrect us once again, and this is easier for him. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِنَّ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ Say, indeed, the very first and the very last, billions, gazillions, whatever, it doesn't matter. قُلْ إِنَّ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ لَمَجْمُوعُونَ إِلَى مِيقَاتِ يَوْمٍ مَعْلُومٍ Well, surely they will be gathered on a fixed day. On a fixed day, that is the day of judgment. That miqat, the timing, has been always the focus of questioning by the non-believers, as well as by the believers. The believers who wanted to know when is it in order to prepare for it. But once they received the answer that none besides Allah knows about it, they settled and they just prepared for it. The non-believers have been always sarcastic. When is it? Bring it on. وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ And Surah Yasin is full of ayat like that. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم. And surely they will be gathered together for an appointed meeting of a known day. That is the day of resurrection. يوم القيامة. Then what is going to happen after?
ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون.
Then afterward, Allah is addressing الضالون المكذبون. الضالون is plural of what? ضال. In Surah Al-Fatiha, every time we recite it, we say what? Guide us to the straight path. Not the path of those who erred and incurred your anger and wrath, nor those of who went astray. الضالين. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. So الضالون, if it is subject, الضالين, the direct object. And both, its singular is ضال, a person who erred or went astray. ضل طريقه means he went astray. He did not go in the right direction. Allah is addressing them. Those who erred, those who went astray. ضالون and مكذبون. مكذب is different than كذاب. كذاب is a liar. But مكذب is a denier. They denied what? They denied either one of the components of belief in Allah and in the last day altogether. So, whether you believed in Allah and disbelieved in the last day, or vice versa, it will not be accepted. That is called مكذب. And he's addressing whom amongst الضالون and المكذبون? الضالون and المكذبون of every nation from the time of Nuh عليه السلام until the end of time. Those who denied the message of their prophets. Those who erred and went astray and did not follow the guidance. Allah is calling upon them. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ أَيُّهَا الضَّالُّونَ الْمُكَذِّبُونَ Most surely you will face the following.
لَآكِلُونَ مِن شَجَرٍ مِن زَقُّومٍ
You shall end up eating in hell from the tree of الزقوم.
إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُومِ طَعَامُ الْأَثِيمِ كَالْمُهْلِ
يغلي في البطون كغلي الحميم. What kind of tree is it? It's a terrible tree that would only grow in hell. Is it like, does it have fruits? Does it have food? No. Rather, it will be the most awful food. Thorny will shred their stomach and their intestine. So why would they eat it? I mean, if somebody knows that he's eating thorns, why would he eat it? They will be forced to eat it because there will be an extreme hunger as well as an extreme thirst, so they will end up eating their fill from al-zaqqum and drinking their fill from al-hamim. And al-hamim, as we mentioned repeatedly, is the boiling water. You know, this is a nice drink. I can't drink it right now. I have to wait until it cools off a little bit. Because once it was prepared, it was at the boiling point. No one can drink a drink or the soup at the boiling point, right? It would just skin off the membrane of your the liner of your mouth. It would burn your tongue. It would burn your stomach. But that will be their drink. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَآكِلُونَ مِن شَجَرٍ مِن زَقُومٍ فَمَالِئُونَ مِنْهَا الْبُطُونَ They shall eat from that awful tree, thorny tree, until they fill their stomach. They would eat their fill. Then what is next? فَشَارِبُونَ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْحَمِيمِ And they shall drink boiling water on top of it. فَشَارِبُونَ شُرْبَ الْهِيمِ Not to think that they will drink a sip or two once they realize that it is burning. No. They will drink immensely similar to the camels. Whenever people used to travel, they will starve the camels and they will keep them thirsty. So when they drink, they would overdrink. They keep drinking, drinking, drinking until their abdomen will be full of water so that they can use this water later on during their journey. فَشَارِبُونَ شُرْبَ الْهِيمِ Also, there is a disease when it hits the camels. They keep drinking until they die. They never feel full. Water will never conquer their thirst. So similarly, those people in hell وَالْعَوْذُ بِاللَّهِ will keep drinking like الْهِيمِ or such camels. هَذَا نُزُلُهُمْ يَوْمَ الدِّينِ That will be their abode, their position, their entertainment, what they deserve, they will get on Yawm al-Din. What is Yawm al-Din? الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. What is the Malik? Malik is the owner. And it's also in another dialect, Maliki يوم الدين. Malik is the owner, Malik is the king of يوم الدين. يوم الدين is what? Is the day of recompense. He's also the king and the owner of our life. But there are a lot of people who might claim that they are the kings in this life, the owners, you know. But on the day of judgment, Allah the Almighty will call. لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ To whom belong the dominion today? And will keep calling several times. No one will answer. Why? There would not be a single living creature other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including the angel of death. Then Allah the Almighty will reply by himself saying, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ Dominion today belongs only to Allah, Al-Wahid, the only one, Al-Qahhar, the irresistible. Now, هذا نزلهم يوم الدين, on the day of recompense, that will be their status and entertainment. نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون, ayah number 57. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will list some ayat to confirm the concept of Al-Ma'ad. Al-Ma'ad means the return, resurrection, accountability, and reckoning. Life after death, or in a simple term, اليوم الآخر. This term which you guys have heard oftenly in the hadith when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر. Let whoever believes in Allah and in the last day. If you truly believe in Allah and you truly believe that there will be a resurrection, life after death, let him do this and that. Or let him abstain from doing this and that of the evil deeds. نَحْنُ خَلَقَنَاكُمْ فَلَوْلَا تُصَدِّقُونَ So Allah in this ayat will remind us of the fact that I created you. So why did he use the pronoun we? إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ It is called the royal we. But Allah is the only one. He is the only singular. But this is called the royal we, the kings, the prime ministers, the big shots, normally express themselves by saying, we decided. And there are human beings who have a beginning and will have an end. They go to the bathroom like us, they get sick and they die. So whenever Allah the Almighty, the only one, the creator, the omnipotent, use the royal we, He's more worthy than anyone else to use it. So this is not even a misconception to discuss it. أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تُمْنُونَ Have you guys seen مَا تُمْنُونَ It's like we heard the word تُمْنُون or مَنِي and its derivatives before. Yes, indeed. In Surah Al-Najm, Allah the Almighty says in ayah number 46, وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى مِنْ نُطُفَةٍ إِذَا تُمْنَى Okay, that's once. Allah is speaking about the creation of the males and females. From what? From نُطْفَةٍ إِذَا تُمْنَى From الْمَنِيِّ مِنْ مَنِيِّ يُمْنَى So the word مَنِيِّ refers to the semen, the sexual discharge. Okay. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تُمْنُونَ Have you seen the human semen that you emit, the sexual discharge? Yeah, what about it? أَأَنْتُمْ تَخْلُقُونَهُ أَمْ نَحْنُ الْخَالِقُونَ Do you guys create it? Do you make it by your own selves? Or is it Allah who creates it? And the answer is already known. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the gradual process of proving who is the creator. And gradually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to state and confirm that as He created the first creation, He is most capable to bring it back after death. As is, نَحْنُ قَدَّرْنَا بَيْنَكُمُ الْمَوْتَ وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَسْبُوقِينَ We have ordained death amongst you for all human beings to die. وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَسْبُوقِينَ I will not to be overcome. عَلَىٰ أَن نُبَدِّلَ أَمْثَالَكُمْ وَنُنْشِئَكُمْ فِي مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Which means we're not to be overcome to transform you and create you in different forms and shapes
that you do not know when on the day of judgment. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He will resurrect us as is, as we, different sizes of course, but the same human beings will be resurrected, the same souls, because it doesn't make any sense that the recompense will be given to other entities, to other living creatures. Yeah, they will be given the same name, but the body is different and the soul is different. No. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ, whosoever does a single good deed, even equivalent to an atom, which shall see it, then you shall see it. You, not anybody else. You will be resurrected as you. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ, the criminals, the war criminals, the serial killers, the disbelievers will be resurrected, the same bodies and souls, and the punishment will happen to them, to the same individuals. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمُ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُولَىٰ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and indeed, you've known the very first form of creation. Don't you know it? Don't you guys remember how we were created? In every revelation, in every divine revelation, to Moses, to Abraham, to Jesus, to David in Az-Zabur, to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah has informed us repeatedly that He created Adam and Eve. He created Adam from what? Then He breathed the soul into him and He made him a living human being, and from He created. So everybody knows An-Nash'at al-Ula, the very early creation. Well, if this is the case, وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمُ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُولَىٰ فَلَوْلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ, why don't you then remember or take heed? يعني, logically speaking, if you have any problem or any doubt concerning resurrection and life after death, simply remember how were you created in the first place. And if you think it is impossible to be resurrected, think about the first creation. The first creation was from nothing. Then reviving a person or somebody which existed before is a lot easier than creating something from the scratch. In either case, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it is all easy. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, isn't the one who created the first creation indeed able to revive it? Yes, indeed. We'll take a short break and we'll be back inshallah to enjoy the recitation of this ayat. Please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud. Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. I would like to remind you with our phone numbers, and we'll be more than happy to take the calls of those who would like to recite this ayat with us today. Area code 002-01-0246-4583. Alternatively, area code 002-01-25-00-8679. Without any further ado, we'll start with our studio guest reciting from ayah number 41 through ayah number 62, inshallah. Brother Izzat, go ahead and recite, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين وكانوا يصرون على الحنث العظيم وكانوا يقولون أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون أوآباؤنا الأولون قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الهيم هذا نزلهم يوم الدين نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون أفرأيتم ما تمنون أأنتم تخلقونه أم نحن الخالقون نحن قدرنا بينكم الموت وما نحن بمسبوقين على أن نبدل أمثالكم وننشئكم فيما لا تعلمون ولقد علمتم النشأة الأولى فلولا تذكرون
ما شاء الله حسبك بارك الله فيك Brother Nasser from Oman, assalamu alaikum and welcome to correct your citation.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Okay, I believe you already know that today, inshallah, we're reading from ayah number 41 through 62 of Surah Al-Waqi'ah. Please proceed on.
Ayah number?
41. وَأَصْحَابُ الشِّمَالِ مَا أَصْحَابُ الشِّمَالِ
أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين وكانوا يصرون على الحنس العظيم وكانوا يقولون أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون
يا ناصر I want you to switch brother Nasser I want you to switch to thin the ta of turaba and fatten the za of izama. وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ
أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ أفآباؤنا الأولون قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الهيم هذا نزلهم يوم الدين نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون
فلولا تصدقون the dal is thin and make sure we don't confuse the dal with the ضاد بارك الله فيكم brother Nasser from Oman we have already sister Reem from the KSA السلام عليكم
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
how are you
I'm fine الحمد لله how are you Sheikh
الحمد لله wonderful From ayah number 41, please, of Surah Al-Waqi'ah, wa ashabu al-shimali.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين
ريم.
وكانوا
ريم.
يسرون على الهمس العظيم
ريم can you hear me? Okay, there is something called the natural mad, which is only two counts. If you exceed the count, it doesn't become natural at all. So for instance, when we say في سموم وحميم, look at the word في, the preposition في, that's called natural mad. The فاء has there كسرة followed by ياء, non-vowel ياء. So this non-vowel ياء will give an extension to the زير or to the كسرة, an extra count. So maximum it will be two counts. So I should say في سموم وحميم. Imagine when I say في سموم, that's not right. في سموم وحميم. Similarly, when I say لا بارد ولا كريم, the word لا, which means neither, okay, it's a negative. The lam itself, the literal lam, it has a zabar, fatha, followed by a non-vowel alif. So this alif is a natural extension of the fatha. So it becomes لا بارد, لا بارد. Why? It's a natural mad. I'm not supposed to exceed the two counts by saying لا. Okay? Except in some cases, of course, like if it is followed by Hamza, which we'll show that inshallah when we come across one. Go ahead and continue, please.
في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين
قبل إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين
ذلك إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين وكانوا يسرون على الهمس العظيم وكانوا يقولون أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون أو آباؤنا الأولون قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون ناقلنا من شجر من زقوم.
Okay, Reem, I want you to listen to me while looking at the ayah. لآكلون
من شجر من زقوم لآكلون.
Okay. طيب بارك الله فيك ريم. We have Rayan from the KSA. السلام عليكم ريان.
وعليكم السلام.
How are you?
Fine, الحمد لله.
الحمد لله. From ayah number 41, please. وأصحاب الشمال.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين وكانوا يسرون على الهنس العظيم
fat in the sod, not to confuse it with the seam, because the meaning will be entirely different. Yusirruna, they make a secret. They talk secretly or they converse secretly. That's yusirruna. But yusirruna means from israr, which is insistence. They used to insist. وَكَانُوا يُصِرُّونَ عَلَى الْحِنْثِ الْعَظِيمِ
وَكَانُوا يُصِرُّونَ عَلَى الْحِنْثِ الْعَظِيمِ وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ أَيْذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ أو آباؤنا الأولون قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الحين هذا نزلهم يوم الدين نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون.
حسبك ريان بارك الله فيك. محمد from Jordan, please try again. We have Amr from Egypt. السلام عليكم عمر.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
We're reciting today from number 41. Please begin.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا ذلك مترفين وكانوا يصرون على الحنث العظيم وكانوا يقولون أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون.
Brother Amr, Amr, do me two favors. Number one, keep the handset away from your cheek because you're pressing the buttons. That's number one. Number two, recite the whole ayah together. And number three, that's the third favor. Send the letter ta. It is not ta. So you will say, وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ. Please recite this ayah again.
وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون أو آباؤنا الأولون قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم
يوم معلوم. That's إدغام وإدغام.
لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الهيم هذا نزلهم يوم الدين نحقناكم فلولا تصدقون أفرأيتم ما تمنون أأنتم تخلقونه أم نحن الخالقون نحن قدرنا بين الموت وما نحن بمسبوقين على أن نبدل أمثالكم وننشئكم فيما لا تعلمون.
As long as you said نبدل, then obviously it is وننشئكم, not وننشئكم. على أن نبدل أمثالكم وننشئكم.
على أن نبدلكم وننشئكم فيما لا تعلمون.
طيب جزاك الله خيرا, بارك الله فيك عمرو. Anyway, we ran out of time. I would like to thank you all for joining us. بارك الله فيكم. And by the end, I can't but thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us from Ahlul Qur'an, alladhina hum Ahlullah wa khassatuh. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. And until next week, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation, and we were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.